May we call in our center court, Marc Pingris!
Yo-yo reverse inside the pin!
Aside from talent and skill, good vision is one of the most important aspects on and off the court. And since competitive sports require more than just physical and mental agility, having excellent visual skills are needed to ensure eye-hand coordination as well as dynamic and static visual acuity. Good day, this is Migs Bustos. And welcome to Shinagawa TV. And joining us today are Dr. Carlo Adraneda, resident ophthalmologist at Shinagawa LASIK and Aesthetic Center.
Hello everyone, welcome to Shinagawa TV.
And of course, we have with us former Magnolia hotshot, Gilas Pilipinas icon, and one of PBA's 40 greatest players. Walang iba kundi si the Pinoy Sakuragi, Marc Pingris. Hi Marc, Dr. Carlo, thank you so much for joining us here today. Marc, baka pamilyar to sa'yo.
Nakakamiss nga eh. Nakapractice kami rito eh.
Pero syempre, Doc Carlo and Marc, pag-uusapan natin ngayon about sports and of course on how good vision is very important. Mm-hmm. Pagdating sa hindi naman importanteng athlete ka, recreational player, or somebody that's kahit very active yan, kahit para kanino. Doc, tatanungin ko lang sa'yo, how important is it for athletes to have good eyesight?
Good vision is imperative. Napaka-importante niya. Pag maganda yung vision mo, maganda yung aim mo, mas mabilis yung reaction time mo kasi maganda yung peripheral vision mo eh. Pangalawa, yung depth perception mo, yung perception mo ng malayo, malapit, mas kalkulado mo rin.
Pero Marc, para sa'yo, tatanungin ko rin yung tinanong ko kay Doc, gano'ng ka-importante yung meron kang good eyesight pagdating sa laro?
Of course, very importante yan. Lalong-lalo na sa, katulad ko nga, sa isang basketball player. Pag mali yun, kumbaga malabo sa game, mahirap yun, nakakapagod. Hindi ka makagalaw, hindi ka makashoot, di ba?
Usually, sa mga athlete, ang mga problema nila, may eye grade talaga yung mata nila. Eye grade, mana-mana naman yan eh. Hereditary, Mahirap nga naman mag-training, maglaro, kung naka-contact lens ka. Usually, eye grade talaga. Yung iba, ang mga visual problem, like mga natotrauma, nagkaroon na injury.
Like, nangyari sa akin yun.
Sige, Marc, kwento mo yung nangyari sa'yo.
Finals against Rain or Shine, I think game 3 or 4. Hindi naman sadya ni Kinyahan, nasundot niya yung mata ko. Talagang scratch talaga yung eyes ko, Doc. So,
na-scratch yung cornea mo.
Yeah, nun. So, sakit. Yung nga, Doc, kahit yun isa lang yung scratch na ano, nadadama yung isa.
Iyak ka ng iyak. Pag masakit kasi yung mata mo, nagkaroon ka ng abrasion, common reaction mo talaga, magluluha ka ng magluluha.
Okay.
So yung other eye, hindi naman na-scratch, pero yung tear reaction mo, pati yung kabila, mag-iiyak
din. Nangyari sa akin, Doc, dahil ang ginawa sa akin, yun, pinasuot ako ng contact lens nga, and then pinapatakan ng anesthesia lang. Siyempre, hindi ako sanay. Ang hirap sa akin. Lahat ng galaw ko, you know, talagang parang kailangan, dito lang muna, ganyan-ganyan, dahil hindi ako sanay eh. So, pag sinusot, yun unang days ko pa, nahihilo pa ako. Pag tinanggal ko naman, may hilo din ako. So, napakahirap talaga.
So, eventually, lumabo yung mata mo?
Lumabo yung mata ko.
Dapat, una, very important, pa-check mo talaga sa ophthalmologist yung mata. Huwag kayong magpatak ng kahit ano lang na makikita sa bahay. Kahit yung mga dating gamot, huwag din. Make sure you have your eyes checked by a professional ophthalmologist para makita kung ano talaga yung naging problem. I'm sure the opta will prescribe medication para dun sa matanong patient.
Actually, 2019 yung nangyari, di ba?
2019.
Tapos,
18, I think.
2018. 18. Tapos, 20, I think few months ago.
Few months ago. Parang mag-one month pa lang ako ngayon.
Nagpa-LASIK.
Kasi nung nagpa-LASIK ako, you know, Shinagawa talagang nandiyan na yung mga gamot na ibibigay sa'yo bago ka umuwi. Yun yung maganda. Tapos sasabihin sa'yo lahat ng gagawin sa'yo. So, andun na lahat. Kompleto na yung mga gamot na binibigay sa'yo. And pababalikin ka rin kinabukasan to check up ulit yung mata mo. And of course, parang nalungkit kasi ako dahil sinabihan ako ng doc na parang mga siguro 2 weeks or 1 week ka muna.
Walang laro.
Walang laro.
Ayun naman, Doc. Pahinga
muna. Alam ng mga tao, nagdo-dota ako. Pinakagusto ko yung Dota. And also, yun kasi nagra-ride din ako. bawal ng hanggang ano, 1 month, so August 7, ilang days pa lang para mag-ride na ako. So, yun, sinunod ko lang talaga yung sinabi sa akin ng doktor.
Now, just to, you know, clarify with Doc Carlo here, I've had my LASIK last April 2019, and when my friends found out about it, yung mga nagbabasketball kong friends, tinanong nila sa akin, Migs, matagal ba ang downtime niyan? Gano'n ako katagal hindi pwede maglaro? Actually, Mark, yun yung tanong ng mga kaibigan ko eh.
Gusto ko na itanong kay Doc, diba? Yun. Doc, kasi yung question ko is, pag nagpalisik ka nga ng mata, bawal ka bang
maglaro,
kasi
agad?
Maglaro agad, or siyempre, delikado yun pag natamaan agad or na-scratch ulit, di ba?
Gano'ng katagal?
As much as possible, especially if contact sport yan, 1 month.
1 month talaga.
But you can train a week or two after. Pwede kang training.
Run, pwede pawisan, Doc? Pwede pawisan?
Yeah, pwede. Weight training, pwede mo yung gawin. But if magko-contact sport and very competitive na yung laro, mas maganda 1 month, no? Okay. Bilis ng healing ng with LASIK. Usually, di ba, na-experience nyo, masakit nung una, di ba?
Napupuwing,
umiiyak. But after 4 to 6 hours, nung kinagabihan, medyo na-open mo na.
Na-open na.
And then, kinabukasan, when you woke up in the morning, okay na eh.
Okay na,
maganda na, malinaw na talaga. So usually, ang bilis naman ng healing. But for safety reasons, dapat mga pahinga muna tayo ng a week. But you can run, you can jog, you can bike.
Saka importante, Doc, yung gamot na binigay sa'yo.
Patak, yeah. Yeah. Provided naman ng clinic yung gamot.
Kasi hanggang ngayon, mag-isang buwan na ako.
Meron pa din, yeah.
Meron pa rin.
That goes for land sports. What if swimming, Doc?
Ah, okay. Mas maganda talaga, more than a month or two.
And
naka-goggles dapat.
Okay.
Yeah,
all right. Pero Doc, pagdating sa LASIK, meron bang hindi nagka-qualify for it?
Maraming hindi nagka-qualify. That is why sa Shinagawa, we take pride doon sa aming pag-evaluate ng patient. Una, pasyente 17 years old and below, as much as possible, wag muna. Hintay muna tayo. 18 above, yan, pwede na. Sunod, ang mga hindi magka-qualify, naalala mo, Mark, naalala mo, sir, nung pagdating yung clinic, check tayo ng mga eye grade, yes, yeah. Maraming grado, yeah. Screening, no? Very important. Kasi we have to check ano ba yung grado talaga ng mata mo, the cornea, yung part ng mata natin na nila-laser, gaano siya kakapal. We go through comprehensive eye screening para malaman talaga natin if you are qualified.
Remember, kinikwento sa akin ni Mama D, mami ni Danica, din na Bonnie Wino, na sobrang labo ng mata niya, pero hindi siya, yung nga, Doc, bakit sobrang labo pero hindi siya candidate sa LASIK?
Una, baka masyado mataas yung eye grade for the thickness of the cornea. Yun yung mga very important na tinitingnan namin. Hindi pwedeng kahit anong grado, gawin mo na, LASIK tayo.
So, hindi basta-basta rin,
yeah,
Doc,
kasi
pala, no?
We have to make sure na kaya nung corneal thickness mo yung procedure.
Mark, gusto kong balikan yung experience mo. Kasi real talk lang, guys, ah. Siyempre, kapag yung mga friends natin na gusto magpa-LASIK, meron talagang may kaba factor ng konti. Ano bang mangyayari?
Oo, nakakatakot.
Ano bang ganito? Siyempre, hindi mo alam eh. It's only gonna be once that you're gonna be doing this. Pero Mark, para sa'yo, ano yung naging experience mo yung preparation?
Okay. Hindi naman ako magsisinwaling, no? Noong una talaga, natakot din ako.
Totoo yun.
Siyempre,
ako rin.
Natakot din ako. But salamat talaga na sobrang ano, ang bilis lang kasi nung pagkalinis sa mata ko, yung pagka-LASIK nila. Salamat sa tulong ng mga doctors doon sa akin, talagang naging smooth talaga lahat. Maganda nga rin, bibigyan ko na rin sila ng tip.
Sige, maganda yun.
Maganda rin sana kung magpa-LASIK sila sa akin na para sa akin hapon, dahil sa gabi pikit ka na lang, tulog ka na lang. Kasi pag sa umaga, the whole day nakapikit ka. So mas maganda para sa akin hapon.
Dalawang common na problem after LASIK. Dryness, no? Napansin niyo laging nagda-dry yung mata.
Yes, Doc. Yeah.
Pangalawa, halos and glare. The start meron, but nawawala din.
All right, so before we take a break, ang gandang discussion namin between Mark and Doc Carlo, napapasarap ang kwentuhan. But before we take a break, let's answer a question from our social media page, Doc. Ang tanong dito, I had blunt eye trauma. Since then, my vision also became worse. Can LASIK cure this?
Blunt eye trauma.
Yes, Doc.
Diyan pumapasok yung importance ng screening. We have to check talaga if candidate yung patient or not. We have to see if ano yung mga naging problema ng pasyente after the trauma. na kung pwede ba siyang i-LASIK or hindi.
Alright, thank you for that, Doc. But we'll just take a break. We'll talk more about sports-related vision problems and their cures when Shinagawa TV returns.
The Shinagawa LASIK and Aesthetic Center can give you a clearer life that you've always been dreaming of.
Ravena gets it in the air.
Ravena will save it. Dani Ravena again.
Good day, this is Migs Bustos and we are back on Shinagawa TV and we're still talking about the importance of good vision, especially with sports. This time, and still with us rather, Shinagawa LASIK and Aesthetics Center resident ophthalmologist, Dr. Carlo Adraneda. Hi, Dr. Carlo.
Hello, everyone. Hello, Migs.
And this time we have with us UAP champion libero, who also comes from a prominent family of athletes, walang iba, Dani Ravena. Hi, Dani.
Hi, everyone. Hi, Migs. Hi, Dani. Hello, everyone.
Hi, Dani. Okay, so Dani, kanina we had Mark earlier and we talked about his story.
Yes.
Kasi sa kanya acquired it from his work, from a game. But for you, Dani, you have a different story. Can you tell us about the story of your, since you were a child?
Actually, like you said, family of athletes, so you'd expect that everyone will have like good vision, good eyesight. But when I was a baby, my mom told me na I was kind of underweight. So they had to put me on medicine na had like steroids daw po. So the side effect daw would be poor eyesight gradually. So I think since I was 8, I was already wearing prescription glasses. And then until in college now, like I would have different glasses every year and contacts were made because I can't just go to the store and buy off-the-counter contacts because my eyesight was too high. So my left and my right were both like, my left rather was 400 and then my right eye is 200. So I still had astigmatism. So it's really hard for me to just buy glasses and buy contacts talaga.
Nagkaroon ka na ba ng experience in-game na natanggal yung isang contact?
Actually, I don't think people know this because I don't share it because it's a secret nga.
So exclusive or, exclusive dito yan. Okay.
So during our finals game, we were in Araneta. We were playing in Araneta and my contacts during the warm-up, it wasn't, I don't know what was wrong. Maybe it had a scratch on it po. So the lights were glaring. So sabi ko, oh no, should I remove it? You know, when it's finals, parang you don't want any extra factors bothering you because you want your full focus on the game. So during that first game, I think I only wore it in the first half of my game and then after I took it off. And then we lost. So we lost our first finals and then it was a best of three luckily. And then the next game, I didn't wear it na. I was like, bahala na. Yeah. I wouldn't want it to bother me anymore.
So hindi mo siya sinuot? As in like?
As in like, the lights were glaring. So it was pretty hard, you know, in volleyball pa. The delay of like a second is so crucial.
The reaction time is
very exactly
important.
Yes. The reaction time for me, especially being a defensive specialist. So after the second game, luckily we won and also in the third game. So I think that was the secret for me to not let anything bother my eyesight na talaga.
Yeah, that's why I mentioned heart strong kasi no matter what the challenges are, you will always give it your best.
I understand it's very hard for athlete na magsalamin or mag-contact lens because it is another factor na naiisipin mo pa instead na dapat malinaw na agad yung vision mo. Mahirap talaga meron kang salamin na suot.
Doc, perhaps you get this question a lot kasi may mga commonly kapag nearsightedness, siguro more or less 1 to 2 steps yung difference ng right and left eye. Pero yung kay Dani, malaki.
Malaki.
400 and 200. Why does it happen?
It happens, that is ano naman, development na lang yan. Pwede talaga magkaroon ng grado na magkalayo. Ang tawag namin doon, anisometropia. Yung isang grade ng mata mo, the difference is more than 200 sa other eye. Mahirap talaga. It's very hard, especially if very important sa kanya yung kanyang far vision, near vision, peripheral vision. Very important.
All right, so Dani, let's talk about your LASIK experience.
Yeah.
You had yours a few months ago. What was the lead up? Nasabi mo, sige, papalasik na ako.
Siguro for me, my mom and I would always talk about getting surgery na ever since. But when we researched about it, you know, you're supposed to have a certain age po.
Yeah.
So to be qualified for LASIK, and also your grades dapat qualified yan. Pag too low, medyo they don't advise
it pa.
Hindi pa muna. And then, you know, also our scheduling po kasi talaga is like the crucial one since we have training twice a day, every day. Like after LASIK daw, we were advised to rest for a while, like 2 weeks or more than 2 weeks. Yeah. So to have that time of rest, parang ang hirap. So ngayon, a few months back, we had time na, and then I can really rest and fully recover. So it was like the perfect time to get it. And then my mom was, without hesitation, she was like, sige, let's go get your surgery talaga. When I went there, syempre, a lot of meetings with doctors, consultations. I really felt at ease na parang, okay, there's a lot of misinformation about it. But here talaga, when I went to Shinagawa, they really explained it. So, you know, I felt like, okay, there's no problem naman. And for sure, I'm gonna be well taken care of talaga.
Susundot lang ako with what Dani said. Yeah. Ang gandang term nun, misinformation.
Yes.
Because ang dami mga kumakalat, word of mouth, pwedeng galing sa source ato, galing sa ganyan. Doc, question, yung procedure ba ni Dani? Is it a unique procedure? Kasi may mga iba-ibang procedure
yeah,
ng LASIK yan.
Yeah, may iba-ibang procedure. Dani got the ultra LASIK, I think, yeah. The ultra LASIK is very efficient, it is very good, especially pagtanggal natin ng mga high grade, lalo na may mga astigmatism. Maganda talaga siya compared to the other machines. Yeah. But okay. The ultra LASIK is one of the best in the market naman, pagtanggal ng drag.
Pagdating sa surgery time, Doc, how long does it take? What usually happens?
Yeah. The surgery time, more or less, nasa 10 minutes lang naman siya. Both eyes na yun. And then, i-guide ka naman doon. The doctor will talk to you habang under the surgery tayo. The doctor will tell you where to look para relax ka lang. But relatively, very fast naman. 10 minutes.
So, you know, the reassurance of the doctors were really helpful. And, you know, the pain, none at all. I mean, siguro a little bit, but
may discomfort,
it's,
yeah.
But
totoo naman.
That's just discomfort, but the pain talaga, it wasn't there. So for me, during the surgery, it was like a good experience overall talaga.
For you, Dani, what's good about Shinagawa?
Siguro, what's the best thing about Shinagawa is like the comfort. Especially for me, siguro us young ones, we're really, you know, we have a long way to go. So you also athletes, parang you want long-term results. Na parang, syempre, I'm also a student, so I really want na, oh, when I read books or when I use my laptop, like almost for long hours a day, parang I wouldn't want naman that will affect my eyesight also. So, yun naman, it's those little things na really matter most for me, especially being a student athlete na, like what I said, parang it's the little things. And you know, after the surgery, like what I said a while ago, super good investment.
At Shinagawa, walang injection. No? Bladeless ang surgery natin. From start to finish, puro laser lang talaga.
Now, meron pong tanong dito from Facebook. Despite my poor vision, active ako sa sports since I was young. I'm now 36 and although my vision has become even worse, I never had my eyes treated. Late na ba na mag-LASIK?
Hindi pa naman. Ang gusto natin, again, age 18 and above, as long as you pasok ka dun sa age group natin, pwede pa. Again, it is very important to have your evaluation dun at the clinic para malaman natin if ikaw yung good candidate for the procedure.
Okay, ako may follow-up question ako para kay Dani. Dani, I know that you guys have a court, a whole gym setup at home. Sila keeper, sila 30 naglalab. Do you also play with them?
I'll play basketball. Siguro saling kit-kit lang sometimes. You know, when you wanna really sweat lang a little bit, you'll just
papawis
join them.
Yeah,
papawis lang. Ganun.
Well, how has it been like, siguro, after your surgery, kapag siguro nag-gym kayo, shooting kayo, how's it like? At
actually, like, people would say OA, but for me, it's really life-changing.
Okay.
Especially nga, parang in volleyball, I'm, you know, when the ball is coming right at you, you think it's far, but then it's right on your face. So, yung mga things na ganon really was changed for the good. So, kitang-kita ko na lahat ng ball. So, no excuses na tayo for my coaches. Bawal na, coach, di ko nakita. Coach, malabo eyes ko. So, lahat clear na.
Tsaka
so,
pare-parehas na kayo nila, kuya.
Yes,
same na.
Partida, ano pa yun. Malabo pa yun.
So, yours is 2010?
Yes,
2010.
Even better than 2010.
Yeah, better than.
Yeah, all right. So, very informative discussion right here with Doc Carlo and, of course, Dani. So, we'll talk more about sports-related vision problems and their cures when Shinagawa TV returns. Good day, guys. Once again, this is Migs Bustos and we are back on Shinagawa TV. Nagbabalik po, Marc Pingris, of course, with Doc Carlo and Dani Ravena. Now, we'll talk about Jose Siquer. Ano kayang pwede mangyari? Marc, personally, nung tapos ka na magpa-LASIK, ano yung na-experience mo?
Sobrang saya ko dahil nababasa ko na ulit yung mga gusto kong basahin. Like before, pag wala akong salamin, hindi ko nababasa eh.
Like Kuya Mark, super excited ko para after so na maglaro, like come on, let's play na. But then, you know, I had to rest in for a while, but you know, kumbaga yung motivation ko na bago eh, because I have better eyesight. Mm-hmm. I really want to perform better pa. So I'm really thankful, like yun nga sabi, parang the doctors are excellent, like super, I felt like home, if not parang they will really comfort me. And you know, yung takot nga, sa umpisa lang yan, but
lang yan.
You know, everything's really taken care of sa Shinagawa.
Doc, I will ask you, how soon will the eyes heal after LASIK surgery?
After LASIK, 4 to 6 hours, medyo masakit yung mata mo after. But mag-heal na yun after nun. The next day, maganda na yung vision mo agad. Hmm. Actually, yung iba, gabi pa lang after the surgery, okay na yung vision nila eh. But healing, day one, malinaw na, kaya mo nang i-open yung mata mo, comfortable ka na. And then, habang tumatagal pa, your vision gets better.
Doc, what would you advise on the first few days, few months? Kasi may mga check-up yan eh.
Yeah.
A day after, a week, a month.
Yeah.
Pero while you're at home, ano yung mga ma-advise mong home remedies post-surgeries?
Sa clinic, after your surgery, bibigyan kayo ng kit.
Yeah.
Na merong gamot na ibibigay na yung Shinagawa for you to play sa mata nyo.
Hmm.
And then, it's very important na sundin natin yung schedule kasi it will maintain your vision, it will help you, your eyes heal faster, better, and then to prevent other na complication na ayaw natin mangyari. So, una, very important yung mga gamot. Sunod, you can do your daily activities naman at home. Huwag lang masyado nating abusuhin agad. Yun nga yung maglalaro agad, magtitrain agad. Maganda, pahinga mo muna. But mga activities for daily living, walang problema, kayang-kaya mo yan.
Now, besides basketball, si Mark eh, nagpa-LASIK siya a month ago, couple of weeks ago, and nahihilig si Mark sa mga outdoor activities katulad ng pagmamotor.
Yes.
Mark, kamusta ang pagmamotor post-LASIK?
Now, sobrang saya na. Wala nang kumbaga hassle kasi yun na eh. Nakasalamin ka pa. Minsan, pag maulan, nagmumoy sa loob, kailangan mong tanggalin, ganun. Pag tinagal mo na, malabo yung ano mo, so ihinto ka pa.
Mm.
So, but now, talagang sobrang saya ko dahil parang bumalik din ako sa pagkabata. Naks, na hindi joke lang. Dahil ano eh, lahat na nagagawa ko na ngayon. Dati kasi eh, parang sobrang hirap talaga.
Eh, sa Dota, Mark?
Dota, wow, the best.
Dani, of course, you're into volleyball, pero ano yung tingin mong mga day-to-day activities na nag-improve para sa iyo post-LASIK?
Oh, for sure, being a student, like it's more fun to read, to do homework. Mas masaya eh, kasi parang naiintindihan mo talaga. Unlike before, I would have trouble reading certain books, especially with all the gadgets and technology. Everything's online. So when you spend hours and hours sa computer mo, nakaka-migraine, and you know, it really ruins the vision. But fortunately nga, after the surgery, and siguro because I'm young, I did the surgery earlier, so it had really like better effects for me, you know.
Masarap yung feeling na kapag post LASIK, you'll let go of the glasses.
Yes.
Diba? So, very liberating feeling. So, I could really attest to that. Doc, we talked about maka-checkup post LASIK. Paano ba yun, Doc?
At Shinagawa, after your surgery, you have your 1 day post-operative checkup. That is very important. And then, sunod, checkup mo 1 week after. You have your 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, and then yearly checkup. Binabantayan namin yung grado ng mata. We check, no? We make sure na healthy pa rin yung mata nyo. We make sure na 20/20 or better pa rin yung inyong vision. The LASIK surgery naman, lifetime naman yung change niya sa mata nyo. Marami tayong age-related na mangyayari sa mata natin. Like, pag nag-40 na tayo, lumalabo naman yung pangmalapit. That's why nagre-reading yung mga tao. And then, at some point, pag matanda na talaga, nagkakaroon naman tayo ng mga cataract. These are all expected doon na mangyayari sa mata natin. But yung LASIK, yung malino yung mata mo, that is a lifetime change naman.
Alright. Yeah. So just to debunk the myth na, uy, bumabalik eh. So that's not true.
Pwede kang, after the surgery, at some time, pwede kang magkaroon ng konting grado, especially if medyo bata ka pa nagpa-LASIK kasi nagmamature ka pa. Tumatangkad ka pa, pati yung mata mo nagbabago rin, no? If ever magkaroon ka ng konti pang eye grade at Shinagawa, we do enhancements for free. Magle-LASIK lang tayo ulit, madali na lang siya, you don't have to pay for it. And then, just to get you back to 20/20 vision, if kailangan. I always advise patients then better to watch from afar. Manood kang TV, walang problema. Kesa laging gadget. Isa yun, one way to get your 20/20 vision mo talaga. Talagang manood ka, gamitin mo. Outdoor, magmotor ka. Maganda yun para ma-enhance mo rin, ma-exercise mo yung 20/20 vision mo.
So, kailangan pala pag nagdodota ako, malayo yung
malayo. Malaking screen, malayo.
Alright, so to wrap it up, as Dani and Marc just, you know, telling their stories about their whole LASIK journey and experience. But maybe to wrap it up, Dani, para sa'yo, what can you say about your LASIK journey with Shinagawa?
Oh, definitely life-changing, like what I said. And also, the best investment for me. Not just being an athlete, but being a student as well. You know, my life really changed for the better. If not, nga, parang my daily activities that used to be really hard for me, just like reading and watching TV would be masakit sa ulo ko, strenuous task. After my Shinagawa experience, definitely super gumaan na yung feeling ko. I can do everything and be more efficient. At the same time, being an athlete, syempre.
Yeah, it's true na nagagawa ko ulit lahat yung gusto kong gawin. Especially sa pagra-ride ko, talagang sobrang hindi na-hassle yun ano ko. Yun salamin ko dahil wala na akong dinadala. Na-experience ko rin kasi minsan yun sa practice before na susutin ko, tatanggalin ko. Mas doon ako, ano eh, kumbaga sumasakit yung ulo ko. Ngayon, talagang nagagawa ko na siya lahat. So, thank you. Thank you talaga sa Shinagawa talaga na Doc, sa inyo, thank you. Yun sa experience namin, napakasaya. So, yung mga nakakapanood nito, guys, huwag kayong matakot. Gawin nyo na, kahit hindi kayo, yun nga, so doon sinabi niya, kahit hindi kayo basketball player o kahit ano, kung talagang may grado yung mata nyo, magpa-check na kayo sa Shinagawa dahil promise, mababago ang buhay nyo.
First of all, I would like to thank the three of you for entrusting your eyes sa Shinagawa. Una, if you have your eye grade talaga, and you want to improve your game, no? You have to improve your vision. So, at Shinagawa, we take pride sa aming comprehensive eye screening. We check comprehensively kung ano yung grado ng mata mo, gaano kakapal yung cornea mo. And then, we make sure na walang ibang problem kundi eye grade lang. The technology at Shinagawa is talagang state of the art. We make sure na we keep up to date dun sa mga bagong technology na lalabas. And then, we use it in practice. And then, when you get to the surgery point naman, we make sure that the doctors are well-trained.
Before we let them go, Dani, baka may message ka to our viewers.
Actually, just what we all said, go to Shinagawa, get the eyes checked. It will change your life and it's the best investment ever. So, yes.
Okay. Perfect.
Mark.
So, guys, huwag na kayong magdalawang isip pa. Pasyal na kayo sa Shinagawa dahil mababago ang buhay niyo.
Do Carlo, last?
Improve your vision, improve your game, have your eyes checked at Shinagawa.
So once again, thank you so much for joining us here on episode 2 of Shinagawa TV. Thank you so much to our guests for today, Dr. Carlo Adraneda, Marc Pingris, and Dani Ravena. Once again, ako po si Migs Bustos. And please do follow Shinagawa on all of their social media handles and reminding you that crystal clear vision is what gets you the gold. Stay safe and God bless.